called it, perhaps you can guess, an amazed plot. And in these amazed plots, brothers and two brothers would share stories about their lives, about their journeys of faith. It was an effort on our own part to get to know one another so that in knowledge of each other, we might help each other grow closer to God. Because the focus was in these walks, Jesus obviously walks with us. This is what makes the gospel today so relatable. The two disciples on the road to Emmaus, 7 miles from Jerusalem. Now, some scholars might say, well, is it 7 miles? Was it more than 7 miles? Nevertheless, you're walking on foot 7 or more miles. That's a long way. That's not a short journey from, you know, the church down to the gas station. It's quite a distance, perhaps symbolic of their leaving the faith. They're leaving Jerusalem. They've left the community behind. They're on their way out. And why? What were they talking about? They didn't understand. They didn't get it. What was this all about to begin with? Who was this Jesus? But as they're walking along, Jesus walks with them. He comes into their lives in that very moment, in a moment when they probably needed him the most. Then we see that how that is the purpose of the incarnation. That God enters the world of human suffering. He comes down to our level in order to lift us up. What does he do for those apostles, those two disciples? Well, he teaches them. He walks with them. He opens their heart to him. He helps them begin to understand more fully what this is about and what it means. They have not only new information about who Jesus is, but a direct personal encounter, which leads them back to the community. It makes them rush back to Jerusalem, back to the community of believers, to share their story, to help others uplift their own faith, to help them come to belief. It tells us a couple of different things. This is what makes this gospel for me so relatable to our own journey of faith. Because a couple of things need to happen. St. Augustine so beautifully said, we cannot love that which we do not know. Jesus opens their minds and their hearts to an understanding, a knowledge of who he is. But it's more than just data and information that they take in. It's partly that. And we as Catholics have a duty to know our faith. You might not know it like some of the doctors of the church, some of the theology professors that I have, but we still have a duty to understand what the faith teaches, what it is about. But at the same time, that knowledge must lead us to a personal encounter, a personal experience, an experience that penetrates into our hearts. Because love is built on relationship, but you cannot love that which you do not know. How many people do we know walk away from the faith because they don't get it? They don't understand. Name your issue. There are many of them. People walk away for all sorts of reasons, some of them big and some of them small. But they walk away because there's a lack of understanding and there is a closed door to their hearts. I can remember when I was a teenager, I had felt the same way. I walked away for a while from the faith because I didn't get it. When a personal encounter, a personal experience with the faith launched me right back into this community of believers. To be able to share my own personal experience with others so that they too may have a personal experience of faith. But to understand it and to experience it must go together. That is the message of the road to Emmaus. Jesus walks with us in our doubts, in our uncertainties, in our questions. But our hearts open to hear what the Lord has to say to us, how he teaches us that knowledge must penetrate into our hearts to lift us up to a greater faith. And that faith is not lived in isolation. It's lived within the context of personal relationships so that we too can help others. That was the point of the hospital system another that leads us to a greater understanding and love for our God and for one another. So let us pray today, Jesus, meet and humble us.